Hi, I'm Hanse Herzog, welcome to Co-Create. Our vision is to unite the world community, so we're able to co-create a good life for all. Therefore, we invite you to become part of the world's largest co-creation partnership. To explain more specifically what this means and to get in contact with you, our community, we decided to start a 30 days video challenge. So welcome on day 20. It's Tuesday in the fourth week. Tuesday is always Co-Create Explained. And after having a look in the general overview, then the ecosystem basic, build on that the facilitation approach. And now we're coming to the online platform. So the online platform has always been a crucial point for us, but it's never alone. So Co-Create is not only an online platform, that's very important for us to connect online effectivity with offline meeting, relationship building, and also to give all people the possibility to collaborate and to participate, not only those who using online. But online platform is important part for us, so let's have a look on that. So in general, we have four main functions of Co-Create, four process steps. First is collecting, networking, co-creation, and the self-organization. So very fast, networking, collecting is about collecting all the solutions we already have in form of knowledge, resources, partners, products, to give you an easy access. Networking is really to bring those together. So they know each other, there is peer exchange, you can have conversation with people who are like-minded. And on step three, we have the co-creation, where we know already a lot of, I call them open collaboration platforms, where a company or a region can put on their challenge and teams can apply for that and somebody's winning and doing the project. What we will do is we make strategic challenges, means in the way of the ecosystem approach, we want to create a strong infrastructure to provide you as change maker with the resources you need, like funding, IT platforms, facilitators, knowledge management, communication, and so on. So strategically, we write them as challenges and we invite you to collect already existing knowledge, advices, your efforts and existing projects to collaborate. So it's not then somebody's winning, but we bring all of this together. And the fourth step is the self-organization. We, for long time impact, we want to support organizations, projects to grow on a long-term collaboration, in best case in form of a cooperative, because it's a form of self-organization, self-ownership, and to own the value which is created within the community. And these are our four main steps. The tricky thing now is that we don't want to create a platform to include all of these functions out of two reasons. First, it might be impossible because it's very, very much, it's a lot of effort, a lot of resources, and we would be then a competitor to a lot of open source tools that already exist. So therefore we go for our main approach is collecting what is already there. So we want to provide or create together with you a kernel for the base of the platform. This kernel provides server structure, a data model, and strong APIs, interfaces, how we can connect to different platforms. And this is already where we start to create this meta platform, this ecosystem, through connecting already existing solutions. There are so many maps out there, we don't want to start a new map, but we want to help to bring all these informations together on a single point. So you have, you as user have one map, where you find all the events and all the initiatives which are going on, and not only those who are entered on the map you know. The same is with online shops, to create easy access to sustainable products by connecting already existing online shops. The field of self-organization, there are really a lot of already existing tools you can use. It's just about which you find, which you know, which you can try easily, and so on. in providing this IT ecosystem, we want to give you an easy access. So the development of our platform we see really as a community process. We often think about Wikipedia or Minecraft, where everything is built through the not always the system architecture, but at least the content is coming from the community. It's community created or user created content. If you want to go a step further, like it would be at Linux, the operating system, where even the kernel is developed through the community. So we really want to empower you to create together the tool we are wishing for, and each small puzzle which is connected will bring more value. So at the beginning we might have just lists of links leading you to other already existing platforms, but at least we give this overview and then we can process on the way how we can integrate them. So we create bigger value for you as well for the developers, because they can put together their resources, they shift from a corporate competitiveness for users to a collaboration, and they can create better products for having more impact for themselves and for you. And all this theory I'm talking about now, we would love to pack into a gamification approach. Gamification simply means to give you clear goals, to give you a clear feeling of achievement, about progress, also with some benefits and rewards, to make it more playful for yourself but also for the developers. I think gamification is taking over more and more around the world, and it's a good tool. I see it as a tool, a channel to make the work more easier. So the goal for that, for this evolving ecosystem, is also that this community create around that a very unique user experience, at least for those who want. So the goal is really to create the classic mode, which is more like a platform, and the gamified mode where we have storytelling, maybe with a fantasy skin or science fiction skin or anime skin, where it's more easy and playful to access the huge amount of information. So the basic of the platform is really, I figured out more and more, to have a strong data model, because it's a question how we bring together all these informations. And one last thing, because people were asking this, why anyway do this? Because we have search engines, we have the strong Google. I'm in the opinion that we are in a time where we have so many information that standard approaches, which we know now, have it hard to make sense out of the information, make interconnections. So if you want really to take information from one place, bring it into a different context, into different projects and languages, connect those knowledge in a project with people who work on that, and money as one resource and other resources we need for this project, maybe also connected to places. This is so high density of connectivity-ness that we need a very solid server structure and database to be very specifically which information we want to share with whom and how to interconnect. And therefore I think we need new ways of how to give meaning to data, and therefore also how to connect the meaning between already existing databases. That might be the most difficult part. So I shared in this long but very short time our thoughts regarding the platform so far. Please leave us comments and questions, because we can dive much more deep into this topic. So comments, questions, thoughts, ideas, best practice examples, please share this as comments below. Also, if you like the video, leave us a thumb up and hit the our bell if you haven't subscribed yet to our channel. So this was today Co-Create Explained. Tomorrow is Co-Create in Action, and I wish you a great day and want to invite you to come together to really this big collaboration around the world, so we can create the society we would like to see. All the best, have a great day, bye.